to our topic 2, the product lifecycle considerations in the marketing strategy. Well, it is very important to understand that profits have a predictable pattern no matter which category of products and product line that we are talking about. As already said, profits in the introductory stage are at a negligible level, whereas in the growth stage they are increasing at an accelerating level and are at its peak. Whereas in the maturity and the saturation stage, they start to decline, and in the decline level, they are at its lowest. Every company and every product has to follow the same pattern, though the time period and the size of the line or the size of the stage might really differ. The second point being, in the early stages, the focus is more on product information, because these are the stages wherein you are introducing your product into the market, you are getting the customers attracted towards your product. Hence, the entire focus is on innovating your products, providing new and better techniques and features of a product to your customers. Whereas in the later stages, the focus is on more on brand promotion, in the terms that already the market has been established, the product has been introduced, we have to use heavy brand promotions and advertising techniques to actually get the customers attracted towards a product. Since in the later stages, the competitors have also realized the potential of this market and stepped in already, we need to heavily promote our product so as to maintain a market share. And finally, using market segmentation in the maturity stage to maintain strong and core customer bases. As already said earlier, segmentation is nothing but dividing the market in terms of various targets and in terms of varied customers. Having said that, let's look into what are the strategic considerations in the PLC concept. Well, the first concept being competition. At the introductory stage, competition is given no importance. The growth stage, it is given a little bit of importance. While at the maturity stage, there are many competitors in the market. Slowly, however, the number of competitors get reduced or are negligible with the declining stage, because even they are exiting the market, realizing that there is no more potential in the market. Second being the overall strategic focus. At the first stage, emphasis is laid more on market establishment. At the growth stage, market penetration and persuasion of mass markets are emphasis. Creation of brand loyalty and brand preference is the focus at the maturity stage. Whereas at the decline stage, the strategy aims at the overall preparation for renewal or for innovations. The third being profits. At the introductory stage, profit is negligible, but at the growth stage, they reach at the peak levels and are growing at an accelerating rate as a result of the growing demand. Whereas in the maturity stage, they decline due to increased competition and competitors' products. And at the last stage, the declining volume pushes the costs up and eliminates the profit. And finally, the distribution strategy. At the introduction stage, the distribution is very selective. However, the growth and the maturity stage talks about intensive amount of distribution strategies. And at the declining stage, yet again, the distribution becomes very selective, and hence low-end strategies are used. Having said that, the final one is the advertising strategies. At the introduction stage, the advertising strategies aim at the needs of the early adopters. Whereas in the growth stage, an attempt is made to make the mass market aware of the brand benefits. At the maturity stage, the advertisement is used as a vehicle for differentiating amongst the otherwise similar brands. And at the last stage, however, the emphasis is on low price of the product and minimum advertising expenditure.